I'm Ilyan Saint-Hilaire, and in this video, we're going to talk about MeshCentral support for agent invite codes. If you're going to run a big MeshCentral instance, you'll need a way for people to install the agent on lots of computers. Or if you're doing remote support, you want a way for people to easily be able to access the agent, install it, or run it on their computer so you can hook their computer up to your MeshCentral instance. And there's multiple ways to do this. And so the classic ways, if I switch over to my developer machine here, so the classic ways to do this is you click on Add Agent for one of the device groups, for example, this one, and then you can select the agent, whether it's Windows, Linux, the mobile device, Android, MeshCentral Assistant, and so on, and you can click on the installation type. So this is one way, but you then download the agent and have to kind of give them the agent. So that's not ideal. What you want is a link that you can give them so that they can go and download the agent easily from anywhere. And so the other option is the invite option here. You click on that, and it will give you a link for a certain amount of time. So for example, 8 hours, I want Windows agent only interactive, so only for remote support, no background install. And then I have this link here I can copy, and I will paste it in my browser, and I get access, I have access to the download page for the agent for this device group, lab computers, and I have the Windows 32-bit and 64-bit agents and nothing else. So that's a way you can then copy this link and send it to somebody else. But people have been asking for another way using codes, like a short code or a short name. So that is supported in MeshCentral. It is not enabled by default. So if you go to your config.json, now I have a super, super simple config.json right now. In the domain section of your config.json, so this is a per domain thing, you can say agent invite codes true. So you add this to your domain of in your config.json. Now, before I reset the server, I want to go into, I'm going to click on lab computers, and this is the device group page. And you'll notice there's features, user consent, notification, and AMT. There is no invite code here. Now I'm going to reset the server, go back into that same web page, and you'll see this new feature called invite codes. Now I've already set codes here. I'm going to delete it, just remove that. But normally you would see invite codes is none. So you would go into your device group, click on it, and see invite codes. And then you can click on that, and MeshCentral will give you a URI. And this is basically your DNS name slash invite. So you can click on this, and it gives you a web page where you can type in an invitation code. So by default, you know, if I click here, invitation codes, none of them work, but that's fine. And what you and the page will be available even if you have no invitation code currently active. So it doesn't matter if you have invitation codes enabled for some of the device groups or not, it doesn't matter. As soon as you put this line in your config.json, this invitation page is now present. Now, what I'm going to do is for this device group, I'm going to enable invite codes. I'm going to put 1234. I'm going to say only Windows agent and background only, for example. Okay, so I have my invite code here. And then I can go back to the invitation page, type 1234, submit, and there you go. You're in the correct page. I can also put multiple invitation codes, and as you'll see here, it's comma separated, so 1234, comma 6789, okay. And then I can go click on that link, go to the page, and type 6789, and oops. There it goes, and it works. If I go back and type anything else, it won't work. Okay, so that's good. And so that's the invitation code. I want to show you one more little trick. If you give that link to your user, with separately the invitation code. They have to type it in, but there's a shortcut. You can put interrogation point C equals 1234, enter, and it will just pre-fill the value here. So this is a little trick, but you don't need to use it. So if you say invite interrogation point C and then a code in the URI, then the box will be pre-filled with that code. So then you just need to hit submit, and there we go. So it's a different way of being able to tell your customers or the people you support, here is how to install the Mesh agent. Now, of course, you cannot create the same invite code for two different device groups. So if I go to another device group and try to do it, 1234 and say okay, it will say that code is already in use. So then I can put 2345, and I'll put all agents background and foreground. So then if I go back here, go back to the invitation page, 2345, okay. Then this will be the test device group and I get all my agents here. But if I go back again to type 1234, then I get for the lab, the computers, and I get only Windows. So yeah, this is a different way of being able to invite people to install the agent. Hopefully that was useful. Thank you very much. Have a great day.